Hey guys, what's up? So last month I taught you my new method of folding Yuri Shumakov's mini magic ball, no tape, and it was fantastic. Everyone was able to fold it. Well, almost. Okay, I'll make a redo. But this time, I'm going to show you how to make it using the diagonal grid of creases, which should make it a lot easier to fold, and I'm also not going to fast forward at all. So, it's a pretty long video, but are you up for giving it another try? Well, ready, set, here goes. This is folded from half of a sheet of printer paper. This printer paper is 8.5 inches by 11 inches, and we only need half. So, let's fold in half. Now you could cut this extra half off with scissors, but I'm going to use this letter opener. You just stick the folded edge into this groove and slide it along, and it divides it perfectly in two. If you're interested, I'm going to have a link in the video description for where to buy this. Okay, let's get rid of this sheet. So this rectangle is 4.25 inches by 11 inches, and that's close to the dimension of a dollar, which is dimension 3 by 7. So you can use a dollar, that's fine. Now in case you're using a sheet of paper that's colored on one side and white on the other, I'm going to color this side colored, maybe a little bit darker so you can see it, huh? Okay, so this is the colored side. So this colored side is what's going to end up on the outside of the ball. Let's begin colored side up, and let's fold the short side to the long side. And let's fold this bottom edge to this edge. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Now let's rotate. And let's fold this flap up and line it up with this edge. And now let's unfold this flap and unfold this flap. And let's rotate. Now let's fold this edge to the top. In other words, fold it in half. And unfold, and let's fold this edge to the middle. And rotate, and let's fold this edge to here. You can let this flap swing out. Now let's take this edge and fold it up and align the fold with this edge. Now let's turn over and let's fold in half on the crease. Now let's open it like this and rotate. And let's fold not this first crease, but the second crease. Just pinch it up like this, and let's fold it onto this crease. And flatten, and when we flatten, you see we make this new fold in there. Okay, now let's skip this crease, and let's lift this crease up and fold it onto this crease. So this is what it should look like from the side. Now let's fold this edge to here. And rotate. And let's fold this bottom edge to here. And let's fold this flap to here. So we're just kind of turning the page of a book. Now let's fold this flap up on this crease and fold it down on this crease. and turn over, and let's fold in half. So we've pleated the paper like this. Okay, let's put it onto the white side, or the non-colored side, supposedly, and spread it out. And now let's take not this crease, but the second crease, lift it up, pinch it, and fold it onto the first crease. And when you flatten it, you see you make a new fold in there. Now let's skip this crease, and let's pinch this crease and put it onto this crease and flatten, and skip this crease, lift this crease up and fold it to here, and continue, skip this crease and lift this crease up and fold it onto this crease. And let's fold this edge to this crease. Now rotate, and let's fold this flap to this edge. And let's fold this flap to this crease. So we're just turning the page of the book. And continue. And let's fold the bottom edge to the crease. Okay, let's unfold completely, and let's turn over. Now we need all of these creases to be mountains, and right now they're almost all mountain creases, but let's just go over and make them all mountain creases. So just fold like this, pinch them like this. All right, now let's turn over, so we're on the supposed white side. Now you need to have an odd number of sections here, and you can tell if you have an odd number by folding the flap over to the last crease, and if it folds easily, then it's an odd number. This isn't a complete segment, but that's just fine. We're going to call it a complete segment. If you have extras, you just cut it off so that you have one segment here. You need an odd number of sections. If you have an even number of sections, then you have to cut off the extra. Okay, now let's fold the bottom edge to the top. And unfold, and let's fold the bottom edge to the crease. Remember, we're on the white side. And unfold and rotate. And let's fold the bottom edge to the nearest crease. Unfold, and let's turn over, so we're on the colored side, and let's lift up not the first crease, but the second crease. Just pinch it up and fold it onto the first crease. So it's like that. Now let's fold the bottom edge to the nearest crease. And rotate. And let's fold the bottom edge to the folded edge. And let's fold this flap up. And fold in half. And fold the flap back down on this crease. We're just making a fan. So turn over and fold in half. Okay, so we have our fan. Now let's unfold. So we're on the colored side. And let's fold this edge behind. And let's fold this edge in front. Just one unit. So it's like this. Okay, now we're going to make the diagonal grid. So let's fold this corner up like this and unfold. And now let's fold it to this intersection of creases like that and unfold and fold it to this intersection. And just continue until you have diagonal creases covering the paper. Now there's no intersection point here, but we can fold it to the next crease. And make sure that your fold still goes through these intersections of creases. And continue. And you can also fold this little flap over. And now to make the rest of the diagonal folds, let's turn over and let's unfold this flap. And now we can fold it to this intersection point. And unfold and fold it to this intersection point. And continue making the rest of the diagonal creases. Thank you. Okay, so we made all of the diagonal creases in this direction. Now we have to make the diagonal creases in this direction. So let's rotate and let's fold this flap up like this and continue like we did before. Remember, we're on the colored side. And once again, let's turn over and unfold this flap and continue making the creases. Okay, so we're on the colored side. Let's remake these horizontal pleats right on the existing creases as they were. Okay, so we have it pleated like this, and this is the shorter flap, that's fine. Now, what we're going to do is make a reverse fold on this point right here. So we're just going to push it in like this, and it should be pretty easy because it's on existing creases, and close it up. So it's like that. Now let's skip this flap and let's just stick this point in. So just push it in like that. Okay, and we can leave this flap. All right, now let's open right here and let's fold these two flaps in. So it's like a paper airplane fold. Like that. And let's close it back up, like that. Now let's open here, and let's make another paper airplane fold. Oops, somehow this flap came out of, okay. There, and there. And let's close it back up. So this is what it should look like. Now let's turn over and let's rotate and let's press this point in. Just push it in like that so it forms a box. I'm going to show you the box from different angles, like that. So there's our box, and it can go all the way down, like that. And now let's push here and make part of a box, like that. Now let's turn over and let's pinch here and just push in here. So we're just collapsing the box like that. And let's push here, and we're going to collapse this box. So we pinch here, and collapse it. So this is what it should look like. Okay, now let's open it. And now let's push this crease up. Just grab it, pinch it like that. And let's push this crease up, pinch it. And let's push it back together. So it's like this. I'm going to show you from several angles. All right, now let's pull it apart again. And now we're going to push this crease up. I'm pushing from behind and pinch it like this and push this up and pinch it. And let's collapse. So it's like that. And let's continue. Pull it apart. Grab this crease and this crease and push it back together like this. And pull it apart and pinch here and here and push it together. And we don't need this reverse fold. I don't know how it got in there. Just push it back if you have it. So it's like this. Now let's open it and continue. Here and here and push it together. And open and push here and here and push it together. And continue. Oops, don't need that reverse fold. Okay, so we're right here. Now let's reverse fold here and flatten here and fold this flap here and fold this flap here and flatten. So it's like that. Okay, now let's undo this little fold and unfold this flap. All right, so this is the colored side and the ball's gonna wrap around like that. Okay, so now we're going to make some reverse folds. We're going to reverse fold all of these flaps. So let's start with this one. Just push it in like this and continue. And this last one you can just fold over and rotate, and let's repeat on this side. So let's open here and reverse fold it. And continue. And this last one, like before, it can just fold over. All right, so we're ready to bring these two edges around and attach them to make the mini magic ball. Okay, let's turn over and let's spread it apart a little bit. And let's unfold this end. So just spread it out and let's unfold the flap. So it's like that. Okay, now let's rotate and let's unfold this end. So spread it out and lift the flap up. Like this. Now we're going to take this end and stick it like this, so that the creases line up. And now let's fold this flap over so that this edge aligns with this crease. Like that. And now we're going to fold it over one more time. Make sure that these edges align. So just fold this flap over. We're just rolling it over one more time. Like that. And just pull it apart so that you can make that fold. So it's like that. Now holding it together so it doesn't come undone, stick your finger in like this, and we're going to just remake all of these folds as they were. And looking at the edge here very carefully, you can see that they are hooked. That's good. So let's start out by pushing down here and pinch here and here. And now push here and pinch here and here. And now pinch here and push here and pinch here and here. And now you can just kind of push it together. And now remake the reverse folds on the edges here that got undone. There's just one here. Push that in. And over here, reverse fold, and push this inside too. So it's like that. And we are done with the mini magic ball. And just push the two ends together and poof, there it is. And you can just shape it a little bit to taste however you want. And there you have it. Whoosh. So I hope you found that a little bit easier to fold. And now you can try it with a dollar if you want, or you can just make another one and you'll have two puffy eyes. Woo! Okay, let me know what you think. Hope you guys were able to fold it, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.